In this video of C#.NET, we are going to see the basic program structure of C#. As in the previous video, we have already done the installation. So now, let's see how we can start working with Visual Studio and how we can create a new C# project and see some basic structure of that.
Now to see the program structure of C# program in Visual Studio, let's first create a new application. For that, we'll come to File, New Project. Here you will get this window which will tell you about the different options for creating an application. Like right here, you can see on the left you can choose the particular language like VB, C#, C++, F#, or Python, JavaScript, which type of project you want to work with. Here we'll continue with C#. And right here inside, as soon as you will come in Windows, web, you will get different options of creating the applications. In the beginning, we'll continue for the console application. Let's put a name, say OK. So here you can see your first console application will look like this. The project name which you have taken will come in this namespace, like tutorials.console.app. We will have a deep discussion for this class as soon as we'll start the object-oriented programming, but for now let's keep it in mind, like whatever code you will put, whatever methods you will put, it will all be inside this class itself. Like here you can see we have a main method which will work as a starter, and whatever you will write inside this function will execute first. On the right hand side, you can see there is something called Solution Explorer, which will give you the structure of your current application. On the top, you can see there is a solution with name tutorials.console.app. The solution may contain multiple projects inside. Currently, I have only one project inside with the name tutorials.console.app. But if you want, you can add multiple projects right here inside. And here is your app.config file, which is basically a XML based file which will help you to make any configurational changes in your application. In the reference, you will get the reference of all the related DLL files which you can see right here, and the same references has been used here using the using keyword. In our basic programs which we will do in this beginning, we will not use all these namespaces, so either if you want you can remove them or you can just keep them here. Initially we will only use this system, which is a base namespace for the .NET framework programmings. It will provide you basic data types and some basic classes which you can use in your startup programs. So now in our next video, we'll start writing the code right here inside this main method.